That's
I got abducted
insult.
Before by extraterrestrials.
What?
Do you believe that? Look me in my
what,
eyes.
What the fuck? No,
look me in my
absolutely
eyes.
Fucking
look
not. Because you're still here
look
on the internet raising hell.
Look
no.
me in my eyes.
No.
And tell me I'm lying.
You're lying.
That's the problem. I'm aware of something you're not. We're gonna see though.
What's up with your tongue? Why you always doing your tongue like this?
I don't know, part of my personality. I like to flick my tongue out. Part of my swag. Part of my micro-expressions.
Okay.
I don't know.
Okay.
But I'm aware of something on the I'm aware of shit.
So tell me what happened when you were abducted before we move on.
I told your story like 5 times already.
Okay, I haven't heard this particular story.
Okay,
I'm sure my viewers haven't heard it.
Tell you right now.
Okay, tell me.
I was on a table and my body was on a table.
Okay.
And I was on a ship and it was all metal, like a spoon. And I was looking down on my body and my body was like chest down, looking at the back of my head, and there was some being.
Listen to me very clearly. The ending of the cycle and the coming of the Christ. I am the black man. I am God. I love myself.
I love myself, man.
You feel me? What I'm doing is beyond Martin Luther King. It's beyond Malcolm X. It's beyond what I'm doing is beyond all of that.
New disturbing video of Elegio Bishop and cult members.
Elegio Bishop, also known as Nature Boy.
He calls himself Bishop, Nature Boy, Christ.
Guess what? We have a God. We have our Savior.
Yes.
And his name is Nature Boy. Yes.
DeKalb police arrested Bishop in mid-April after a woman told them she had left a sex cult.
I watched him whip a girl with a leather belt multiple times for 15 minutes straight.
He was extorting money from a young person.
Bishop lived off of other members' PPP loans and life savings.
This is why I decided to leave Melanation.
Brainwashed his ass.
I don't like how the women are being treated.
Tell him who Baba G is. God. Tell him.
Baba G is God.
Oh, somebody feels sorry for Tanisha.
He's kind of mad that...
Of course he's mad. He's always mad.
It's because we're black. I'm just letting you know that right now.
It ain't because of your color. It's because of your nasty attitude and your crazy eyes.
We in the valley of the shadow of death. And we will fear
no evil.
But listen, we will be humble.
So, that's your live right now?
That's my live. Yeah.
Your soul. Will be thrown into the abyss.
Shalom. Call halal Yahweh Bahashem. Yahushai Bahashem. For Chakwadash. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, who taught us his truth and truth and sincerity. Peace and salutations to the hopeful elect scattered abroad. My name is Ibar from the Prophets in Babylon Camp down here in Tampa, Florida. And real quick, I want to go into this topic, man, of fake teachers, okay? Beware of fake teachers, okay? This week's, the individual that's going to be in question this week is going to be this guy, Bishop. His name is, or they call him Nature Boy. All right, and the reason why is because he's in, he's in the middle of a court process, you know, he's in jail and he's been going to court, pretty much for deceiving, you know, Jake's man, okay, and one thing about Jake, which are you Israelite people, you so-called Negroes, Hispanics, Native Indians, you are very, very gullible, okay, very easily to be manipulated, and this is what these people do, okay. You also have this guy, Young Pharaoh. I heard he crashed out by, trying to shoot his baby mother or something. And we know about this guy, Polite. All right. This guy, Polite, which I've done videos on this guy as well. Okay. He, got caught being a pedo. Okay. According to this society, you know, he's locked up doing time, about 7 years now. And the same guy came against our elders and apostles. All right, so you got to be aware of these. And I don't know who this guy is, but it doesn't matter anyways. All right, but there's a lot of these individuals on the internet and have been for the past, 10 years or so, on and off of these guys pretending to be, leaders of our people, and they're not. Okay, the true leaders of our people are the elders and apostles of Great Millstone. Okay, and we know this because they're going to teach you the scriptures. They're not going to teach you some madness from some Egyptology, some, you know, have you throwing up, you know, some occultic ancestors. No. All right. And these guys that do this, they eventually, you know, crash out and end up being, you know, made a public example before the whole world, like these individuals that you see on the screen. So let's grab a few scriptures, and I'm going to go back to this video, because she says a lot of things. This woman in particular, she makes a lot of good points about this, you know, this cult or whatever. All right, so let's, you know, get ready for that. But I'm going to read this first. This is 1 John chapter 4, verse 1. It says, "Beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirit, whether they be of the Most High, because many false prophets are going out into the world." So you can't believe every spirit. Just because somebody comes up and they may have a Bible in their hand, or they got a garment on, or they, you know, have a platform, don't mean that you should believe them. Okay, there's a lot of fakery and disgenuine people out here, man. Okay, it says, "Hereby we know the spirit of the Most High. Every spirit that confesseth that Yahweh Shai HaMashiach, which is who you ignorantly call Jesus Christ, is come in the flesh, in the flesh is of the Most High." Right, and that's one thing that these people don't do. Okay, they believe that they're God, like he said in the beginning. They started to get this, you know, a cult of personality, and they think that they are, you know, the Lord, and you're absolutely wrong. It says, "And every spirit that confesseth not Yahweh Shai HaMashiach is come in the flesh, is not of the Most High." So this is how we are able to discern who's of the Most High and who's not. If they don't believe in the Most High, okay, and His only begotten Son in truth and in sincerity, okay, most of these individuals, they try to see that they're God or they're the Messiah. It says, and this is, or that there is no Messiah, okay, so beware. It says, and this is a spirit of Antichrist. So these are Antichrist. Let's play some more.
Today I want to talk about Eligio Bishop.
That's individuals like this. This guy is an Antichrist, and he's pushing the Antichrist vibration, okay, against the true Messiah. It says, "Wherefore ye have heard that it should come, and know, and even now already is the world is in it in the world already." Salakia. Okay, so we got to understand that this is here. You have many Antichrists among us. It says, because there's not just one Antichrist. There's many Antichrists, as the scriptures say. Let's go to 1 John chapter 4, verse 1 in the NLT. "Dear friends, do not believe everyone who claims to speak by the Spirit. You must test them to see if the Spirit they have comes from the Most High, for there are many false prophets in the world." So you got to test them. Okay, and the best way to test them is according to the scriptures. The scriptures is our guideline. Are they following the scriptures? It says, "This is how we know if they have the Spirit of the Most High. If a person claiming to be a prophet acknowledges that Yahweh Shai HaMashiach came in a real body." So this is how you know if they are a true Messiah. I mean, it's like if they're a true prophet of the Most High, if they acknowledge the Messiah came in a real body, that person has the Spirit of the Most High, right? So, and now even still with that, you got to be well mindful of, you know, who they're saying the Messiah is, and, you know, and what body he came in. All right, so let's play some more.
A.K.A. Nature Boy, a.k.a. Baba G, a.k.a. the God or Three God. Yes, he claims to be God, and his followers claim he's God too. He recently got arrested. Nature Boy is in jail right now, and he's charged with R-word and false imprisonment and other things. But there are people who say that there are more crimes that he committed that he's not been charged for. They say he's responsible for someone's death. They also say he's done some really gross things with kids. So the whole thing started on April 13th, 2020. They arrested Nature Boy and took some of his followers in for questioning. Turns out they were investigating Carbon Nation, that's the name of his cult, for weeks. A former member told cops that she had suffered various forms of abuse from Nature Boy and that she tried to leave before, but he wouldn't let her. And she tried another time. She finally left. And when she did, Nature Boy was pissed. She says that in retaliation for her leaving, he posted videos of her having sex online, which is a crime. It's called revenge porn. And so those were the charges. But as I said, some people think he did more, and there might even be evidence of that, but I'll let you guys decide. When the cops raided girls ready for marriage, a female neighbor said, not giving her name. And then another neighbor said, he controls them, they do what he says, and like I said, it's turned into abuse. The neighbors have been complaining from what I hear. After Nature Boy's arrest.
So this individual, Nature Boy, which there's a lot, you know, I haven't even watched this whole thing. I couldn't get through it. It's a lot of, you know, crazy shit that this individual has done and people like him. Okay, but you got to be mindful of these, you know, of these cults, you know, these occult personalities, these people that pretend to be for your best interest and really, you know, that they're really just, you know, seeking their own interest. Okay, they're narcissists, you know, it's all about them, you know, so you got to be mindful, man. Okay, you got to be mindful. All right, but let's go here. 2 Peter chapter 2, verse 1, it says, but there were false prophets also among the people, even as there shall be false teachers among you. So among our people, there are false prophets and there are false teachers. You know, you got particular guys in these different camps saying the MOTB and the micro C-help. That's a false prophet. But then you have false teachers that's teaching you things that are not according to the scriptures. Okay, so you got to be mindful of these things. You have to be able to discern these different spirits. Okay, anybody that comes up claiming to be, you know, majestic, you know, you got to question them, man. Okay, and we question them through the scriptures. Okay, where does what this individual is telling you lines up with the scriptures? All right, is this a thing of this person's ego, what they want, we know what they believe, or is it lining up with what the scriptures say? Okay, so let's keep on going. And this is how you know somebody is, you know, whether somebody's right or wrong. It says, but there were false prophets also among the people, even as there shall be false teachers among you, who privately shall bring in damnable heresies. And this is what these individuals do. They bring in damnable heresies. Okay, destructive teachings. It says, even denying the Lord that brought them, and bring upon themselves swift destruction. And this is why those particular people you saw in that picture, they are bringing upon themselves swift destruction. And really all their followers, these guys are con artists. They're trying to make money off you people. Okay, this guy said somebody donated him $30,000. Okay, he was saying how they don't take baths. You know, they shit on trees. Okay, and they got kicked off an airport, off an airplane, because people were saying that they stink. Okay, because your ass don't take a bath and you in the sun all day talking about you melanin and all this sun worship garbage. Hey, you're going to start to stink, man, which that's a huge thing for a lot of people too. You know, Jake will tell you some grand rising, which, you know, whatever the purpose for them saying it, it all goes into Egyptology sun worship garbage. And you got to be mindful of this, man. This thing ain't about having melanin. All right, but it showed you in the beginning too how he now then this guy started to allow Edomites, okay, so-called white people into his cult because he was getting all the backlash. All right, so let's read on. It says, and many shall follow their pernicious ways, by reason of whom the way of truth shall be evil spoken of. And these people will speak evil against the truth to keep, you know that deception upon the people that follow them. Okay. And many shall follow their pernicious ways. Let's go into this pernicious ways. All right. Let's go into some of these words, man. Because you want to get a full understanding of what time. And listen, there's going to be many people that's trying to deceive you and throw you off. Okay. So the word for pernicious is apolia. It says destroying, utter destruction of vessels. A perishing ruin, destruction of money, destruction which consists of eternal misery in hell, which we know there's no such thing as eternal misery in hell, but ultimately that thermonuclear fire is coming. Okay, and these people, they will lead you into pernicious ways, destructive ways, that's going to end up getting you destroyed out here, man. Okay, because when the Lord comes back, he's going to, you know, bring fire. Okay, and America's going to be destroyed with thermonuclear fire. So if you don't get right with Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, and you follow these false teachers and false prophets, guess what? You're going to be destroyed with them. Scripture says that the blind lead the blind, they both shall fall into a ditch. All right, let me grab that real quick, just for edification's sake. All right, because that's what's happening. You got Jake being led by the blind. All right, people that really don't, you know, and everybody wants some sense of power. When you want, what you understand is power, great power comes great responsibility, man. You know, me, even me being the head of a camp, you know, I never, you know, wanted to be the head of a camp. I never, you know, aspired. The Lord set it up that way. And people that want power, those are the wrong people to have power. Okay, really the Lord puts power in the hands of the ones who least desire it. Okay, because most people, you know, it's all about their ego. You know, they take power and they abuse it. Okay, they manipulate people. This is not what this is about. And those of you that have power, you know, that are heads of particular, you know, churches or camps or whatever, however you may have it, hey, you are going to have the greater condemnation. Okay. You will be judged, okay, and everything is your fault. No matter what happens in your camp, in your congregation, okay, everything falls back on you, okay? So you got to make sure everything is in order, you know, everything is properly, everything is going according to the scriptures, all right? And that's what these particular individuals don't believe in, right? They're really following their own ways, okay, and glorifying their own selves. It says, this is Matthew chapter 15, verse 13, but he answered and said, every plant which my heavenly Father hath not planted shall be rooted up. Right? You can't come in this thing and make yourself a man of the Lord. If you ain't a man of the Lord, eventually you're going to fall out. Eventually you're going to be rooted up. You see? The Lord has, the scripture says, many are called, but few are chosen. Okay? And the Lord has called us to come into this marvelous light and teach this truth. Now, you have some individuals that may have been called by a man. You know, you may have been called by somebody personally. They may have told you about this, you know, and you kind of got into it because they're into it. But all, at the end of the day, if you're not meant for, if you're not meant for this, if you were called but not chosen, guess what? You will be rooted up. Okay, and that could be any of us. This is why we got to remain humble, remain meek, stay in the right spirit. You know, don't get beside yourself in this thing, because when you do that, you know, the Lord hates pride. You know, the Lord departs from those that are in the spirit of pride. It says, let them alone. They be blind leaders of the blind. And if the blind lead the blind, both shall fall into a ditch. Right. So whoever's do all the people that's following this guy and people like this, you're going to fall into a ditch with them, man. OK, you're going to be destroyed with them. And that's why, you know, there's infighting. I remember I saw a video a while ago. This is years ago of him on at the beach with these women. And he had them women fighting, man, you know, which is completely off, you know. This guy in particular, you know, the video goes into it, but I don't want to show all that, you know, so I'm going to show stuff here and there. But this individual right here, he used to be into, you know, gay corn. OK, he called himself a model. You know, he has a very, you know, weird background. OK, and individuals like this, you got to be mindful of these people, because their main thing is to bring, you know, swift destruction upon you. All right. So let's keep on watching.
His followers remained loyal. They supported him. They spoke to media. They denied the allegations.
We went by the home Thursday afternoon, and several people who say they are Bishop's disciples came out and talked with me.
Basically, the police raided us on false allegations.
Followers who were at Bishop's home.
Now you see right here, they're throwing up because he got this thing 333. You know, it's madness, man. But this symbol right here is an occultic symbol. Okay, it is an occultic symbol. And in fact, let me see if I can find it real quick. Here we go right here. It's just a spirit. I was just looking to this the other day. That's a spirit. Okay, so I just found this picture the other day, and I already had in mind to go into this video. But, you know, it all lined up through the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. So the same, you know, thing right here. You got Barack Obama, Travis Barker, Britney Spears, Brad Pitt, Beyonce, all these individuals, you know, Michael Jordan, you know, all these individuals, they're showing you Kanye West, Jay-Z, yada, 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 which these are all Will Smith, Pharrell, or Pharrell. These are all occultic, you know, members. Okay, they're all are members of the occult. They worship Satan. All right, and here in this video, you got his occult members, you know, in this cult, throwing up the same, you know, the same stuff. Okay, so you got to be mindful of this, and you got to, you know, try every spirit, whether it be the spirit of the Most High, because what people do is they take different doctrines and they mix them. Okay, instead of just, you know, sticking to one or the other, they got to mix a big pot of, you know, bug out stew, and they'll have you out here bugging out on live TV, Fox News, throwing up 666. Okay, because that's really what it is. All right, but they'll say it's 333. No, it's 666. You Jakes are going off, man. So let's go here. It says, let's go to 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 1. It says, Paul, an apostle of Yahushua HaMashiach, by the commandment of the Most High, our Savior, and the Lord Yahushua HaMashiach, which is our hope. It says, unto Timothy, my own son, in the faith, grace, mercy, and peace from the Most High, our Father, and Yahushua HaMashiach, our Lord. It says, as I besought thee to abide still in Ephesia, when I went to Macedonia, that the mightiest charge some that they teach no other doctrine. You see? That thou mightest charge some that they teach no other doctrine. And the problem is, people are teaching other doctrines. Okay, you have false teachers and false prophets out here teaching false doctrines. It says, neither give heed to fables and endless genealogies, which minister questions rather than godly edifying in Swaki, which is in faith. So do. Right, because it just comes a bunch of contention and questions rather than godly edifying. All right, and Jake gets bugged out. You know, people come on the social media, the internet, and they see these particular individuals and they go to follow them. Okay, now realizing that they're leading you, you know, into death and destruction. It says, from which having some swerved, have turned aside unto vain jangling. Okay, 333. Okay, turned aside into vain jangling. This is what happens among our people. They get taken by these sorcerers, okay, by these false teachers, and before you know it, your ass is gone. Okay, it says, desiring to be teachers of the law, understanding neither what they say nor whereof they affirm. We know what it's like, that the law is good. It is if a man use it lawfully. So that's the point. Let me go here. Let me see if I can type this in. Salakia. But let's play some more of this.
On Arbor Chase, the night of the arrest, defended their leader and insisted women are not mistreated here.
He says those criminal accusations are from a disgruntled former member of the Carbon Nation family.
The woman that was here, she gave consent to actually release it for sexual education.
They believe in nature, nudity, and kindness.
Everything that
nature, nudity, and kindness. Okay, which I heard how he was getting all these women pregnant. His ultimate goal was to get he wanted to get pregnant, all these women at the same time. We're still fighting over damn women in there, man. You have particular members who was dealing with a woman. You know, first he was dealing with a woman, then this guy started dealing with a woman. Then he wanted the woman back. Bunch of madness, man. But he was saying how, they were saying how he was, his plan was to get, you know, these women pregnant all at once. And then to, you know, have the children born together. So you can see them, you know, commit the act of incest together. Completely bug the hell out, bro. All right. Beware of these individuals out here, man, because it's a lot of them on the internet. You know, the Lord said, believe not every spirit. 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 1. Now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. And this is one of those. Okay, these Jakes probably grew up, learning about the Bible, and here they are, you know, going all off the deep end with Nature Boy. It says, speaking lies and hypocrisy, having their conscience seared with an hot iron, and a lot of times they don't come back. Okay? They get, you know, taken by that madness, man. Okay? So be mindful of this. You know, don't fall for the okie doke. Don't be simple. You know? Don't be simple. Let's play some more.
Sexually happens among adults.
Correct. Yes.
Consenting adults.
Correct.
They call him God, literally.
God is a very loving being. He's very caring. He's very holy.
This is a revolving door.
You hear that? Three God. They call him Three God. He's caring. He's holy. Be mindful of these smooth words, because this is how they get you, man. Okay? This is how they get you. All right? Let's go here. It says, let's go here real quick, because, you know, these people are simple, bro. Okay, they're very simple. They don't know what's going on. And because of this, a lot of times these people find themselves in, you know, shitty situations. All right, and that's what it seemed like has all been going on with these individuals. Let's go to here. Romans chapter 16, verse 17. Now I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which ye have learned, and avoid them. So if anybody's teaching any false doctrine, any false teachings, we are to mark you. And today is a day that, you know, this guy Nature Boy or Bishop gets marked, okay, for this madness, man. And I remember one of the brothers sent in the chat, you know, his court case. And this nigga sitting in the courthouse, and they go to reading all his charges, and he go to looking crazy at the camera. Nigga. And the crazy part is a lot of things that they saying that he did, a lot of this stuff was filmed, you know, on camera. Okay, so it's completely gone. Putting everything on camera and stuff, it's just weird. Okay, it says, For they that are such serve not our Lord Yahushua HaMashiach, but their own belly. And that's what this guy does. He's serving his own belly. And by good words and fair speeches, deceive the hearts of the simple. And all these women are simple. All these men here are simple. Okay, he has deceived these people through fair words through good words and fair speeches, telling you what you want to hear.
You can come in and out as you please. No one is being, no one is going to hold you against your will.
Women come here, they don't get their way, and they go against the black man.
Black man is God.
The black man is God.
And y'all just locked up the Messiah.
Remember when I did.
You heard that?
Women come here, they don't get their way, and they go against the black man.
Black man is God.
The black man is God.
And y'all just locked up the Messiah.
He said, and y'all just locked up the Messiah. Okay, so these jakes are completely gone. They're flying all across the country to be around this man just to get, you know, deceived. Okay, let's go to Isaiah chapter 9, verse 13. It says, for the people turneth not unto him that smiteth them, neither do they seek the Lord Yahweh of hosts. Right, so they don't turn to the Most High. They don't turn back to the scriptures and Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahushai. They're seeking after these false prophets and these false teachers. It says, wherefore Yahweh will cut off from Israel head and tail, branch and rush in one day. The ancient and honorable he is, and the head of the prophet that teacheth lies. You see, he is a tail. So you prophets that's teaching lies. It says, for the leaders of this people cause them to err, and they that are led of them are destroyed. So if you get led by these false teachers, so like these false prophets, you will be destroyed with them. All right. And that's why this guy is in prison looking crazy, you know, for doing some madness, man. The scripture says that we are, and don't get it twisted. Some of us may be cast into prisons too in these last days, but we're going to be cast into prison for righteousness sake. It's better to suffer for righteousness sake. Okay. Than rather be, you know, let me grab that real quick. All right. Because a lot of people, they say, oh, well, the prophets was cast in jail, but they were cast in prison for doing, you know, the will of the Lord. Not for doing no wicked shit. Okay, not for being in no cult, teaching no occultic, you know, traditions. No, man. Okay? So you got to, you know, reevaluate, okay, what the prophets were actually doing. Let's go here. It says, let me see. It says, this is 1 Peter chapter 4, verse, I'll get right to the point, verse 13. But rejoice in so much as ye are partakers of Hamashiach's suffering, that when the glory shall be revealed, ye may be glad also with exceeding joy. But if ye be reproached for the name of Hamashiach, happy are ye, for the spirit of glory and of the Most High resteth upon you. On their part he is evil spoken of, but on your part he is glorified. But let none of you suffer as a murderer, or as a thief, or as an evildoer, or as a busybody in other men's matters. It says, yet if any man suffer as a Christian, okay, a follower of the Lord, let him be not ashamed, but let him glorify the Most High on his behalf, right? So you shouldn't be suffering because you are a thief, robbing people, you know, extortioning people, you know, a murderer, you know, doing being an evildoer, okay? And that's what's happening to these individuals that you saw on that screen. These guys are you know, getting thrown in prison for their wicked ways and their false teachings, okay? So let's read some more. Or let's play some more. That's the point on that. Well, let me finish this up. It says, for the time has come that judgment must begin at the house of the Most High. And if it first begin at us, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of the Most High? Right. And these guys aren't obeying the gospel. Okay. They're not obeying the gospel of Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai. They're obeying the gospel of the three God, which is this guy is a false God. Okay. He's become an idol. It says, and if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear? Wherefore, let them that suffer according to the will of the Most High commit the keeping of their souls to him and well-doing as a faithful creator. Right. So, coming back to you, Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai.
Remember when I did, so there's so concubines, they went on a live after his arrest and they defended.
We've been fighting and fighting.
Concubines, they went on a live after his arrest and they defended him. They're like, he's God, he's the Messiah.
You cannot box with God. They are simply throwing little pebbles and little stones. We've been fighting for freedom. For freedom. We have a God. Freedom. We have our Savior.
Yes.
And his name is Nature Boy. Yes.
Who is our God to worship? It is three gods. He's literally our Messiah. He's literally Jesus.
He's a silly ass woman. And these same women be on a damn, you know, on his live videos fighting, you know, arguing. He be making them fight each other. You know, they probably all in the same house on a cycle. It's just completely madness, man. Okay, Isaiah 8, verse 20. To the law and to the testimony, if they speak not according to this word, it is because there is no light in them. And these Jakes have no light in them. They're completely gone. Come on, 333. Madness, man. Madness. But this shows you what happens when you fall away from the Most High and fall into idols and demons. Okay?
People wait till after they gone.
Oh. Modern day Jesus is here.
Yeah.
And you will not shush him up. He is the melanated God. He is the first, he is the melanated God that all people come from.
Exactly.
And you judge us. And you throw stones at us when we trying to bring you truth.
In addition to that, his other followers, because he has.
So you heard what she said. It says, Hosea chapter 4, verse 6, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, because thou hast rejected knowledge. I will also reject thee, that thou shalt be no priest to me. Seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy power, I will also forget thy children. Right? So because you forgot the law of Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai, the Lord is going to forget you, you know, and your children. All right? Scripture talk about how people are sottish, okay, stupid children, silly, okay? You really just completely too far gone. Okay, let's play some
male and female followers. They called him probably.
The people that hate me are united.
Yeah.
So you have to get people that love me together.
We'll see you soon.
In the call, Nature Boy mentions how he hopes he gets bail.
Oh, he can be bail.
Well, he didn't. He didn't get bail.
A risk to intimidating the victim. There's also a risk of flight and also the risk of committing an additional felony. So therefore, bond will be denied.
Outstanding.
To understand how we got here, we need to go back to the beginning. before Nature Boy was Nature Boy, when he was Eligio Bishop. According to an ex-member, her name is Erica Carroll, she said, quote, I know his mother and father died while he was a young age, so he was in foster homes, in and out of foster homes. He's originally from New York, but he did gay porn.
You heard that? I'm going to leave it right there. I'm going to keep on going. But the guy did gay porn. They were showing some of his model pictures and stuff. All right, he's completely gone, man. All right, but let's keep on going. There was doubt out living out there in tents. Yeah, this white girl there.
What's Nature Boy like? Because he's quite the character, isn't he?
Here's how I would flip $1,000 if I were broke.
The soil belongs to the trees, and I'm in an abusive relationship with the tree if I'm not giving it back.
And also, you don't need soap, just water, like in the natural waters in nature. So, as you can imagine, there were lots of odors going on. You know Lori Vallow and Chad Daybell, I have like a bunch of videos on them. That would explain this video that I found where he's basically dressed in Middle Eastern garb, and then he's sitting above his followers while he talks about astrology and the ego.
What is the ego?
Good question. The ego. What is the ego?
Because this guy, his ego is inflated, okay? And he asked what the ego, he was asked what the ego was, and he asked another guy. Okay, and listen to his response.
Can you tell me what the ego is?
The ego is one sense of self.
One sense of self, exactly. The ego,
weird as well.
What is the ego? Can you tell me what the ego is?
The ego is one sense.
Now, I don't know who this individual right here is, but this right here is a known pedo, you know, mark right here, man. Okay, a known pedo mark. All right, I'm saying like that for the algorithm's sake, you know, child lovers. All right, and you know, this guy Nature Boy is also known for talking about how he acts around his children, and how you know they see him, you know, indulging in sexual activities with their mom and a bunch of weird stuff. He walks around his children naked and just, you know, folly and madness, man. All right, but I don't want to make this too long. I'm going to close out. I just want to grab a few more scriptures. It says, Proverbs chapter 14. So lucky. Proverbs chapter 14, verse 12. It says, there is a way which seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death. Okay, so be mindful. You got guys that's following the ways of death. It says, verse 15, the spirit believeth, it's like the simple believeth every word, but the prudent man looketh well to his goings. So the simple are going to fall for these false teachers and false prophets, and you're going to believe whatever they tell you, okay? You're going to believe whatever they tell you, and before you know it, you know, you being destroyed with them, all right?
One sense of self, exactly. The ego is our conscious mind. Simply. And we have taken something called pride, or what we protect ourselves with as a protective mechanism. For instance, if you're a Leo or you're Aries, you might have a lot of pride. So what they call the ego would be your pride. You see what I'm saying? And
look at these dumbass zombies. Zombies, man. Okay. It says, Proverbs 14, verse 28, the simple inherit folly, but the prudent are crowned with knowledge, right? So if you're going to be simple, you're going to inherit, you know, just that, folly, okay? So be mindful of this, man. You know, don't be just taken by
the false teachers. Ego with arrogance, these are characteristics of the conscious mind. But the ego is simply your astrological program. Yes? I love myself.
It's giving Dubai meets yoga guru meets bullshit, okay? I don't know how people fall for this and the whole persona and what he's wearing, like, all of them, they're dying. Visas, a lot of them had expired. Things are going good.
So look at this now. Now he got Edomites in there, you know, to try to get more money. Really what it's all about. Now he's dealing with this woman, right? You know, he's standing in front of this woman. But she go back to deal with this man. And then she was first dealing with him. Then she go to deal with him. Then she go back to deal with him. Much of madness, man. But this is what's going on in these damn cults, man. Okay. Let's go to John chapter 10, verse 7. It says, then said Yahweh Shai unto them again, verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. You hear this? Yahweh Shai, red letter speaking. Our Lord is a door. Okay. I am the door of the sheep. All that ever came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not hear them. Right. So the Lord, you know, he don't hear these false prophets. If you're not coming in the spirit of Yahweh Hashem Yahushai, you are a thief and a robber. Okay. The Lord said he is the door. As he says, I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved and shall go in and out and find pasture. Right. Because the Lord is a mediator, not bishop. Not fucking Nature Boy, not, Young Pharaoh or, you know, not any of these guys. It's Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, okay? Our Lord Yahweh Shai. All right, and look at this guy right here. He looks very weird. I wouldn't want him to go around. Anytime they ain't taking baths. All right? Gone. It says, the thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. I am come that they might have life and that they might have it more abundantly. I am the good shepherd, and the good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. But he that is an hireling, okay, which is, you know, somebody just trying to do a job, somebody just trying to collect a check. He that is an hireling and not the shepherd, whose own the sheep are not, seeth the wolf coming and leaveth the sheep and fleeth, and the wolf scattereth them and scattereth the sheep. All right, so there you go. And what's coming is this devil's about to come down with great wrath. And you're not following, you know, the true spirit of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, and you're following these false leaders and false teachers, they're going to lead you astray. They're going to leave you out there. Okay? They're going to tuck tail and seek to save themselves. All right? Rather than remember that you got a whole ministry. You got a whole, you know, church, you know, that you got to, you know, you got to thank for. All right? And that's a true leader. Okay, a true shepherd. Okay, which we have become shepherds as well. But the ultimate shepherd is Yahweh Shai. Okay, and we got to bring them back to the ultimate, you know, shepherd. All right. It says the hireling fleeth because he is an hireling and careth not for the sheep. So he don't really care about the sheep. They don't really care about the people. It says, I am the good shepherd and know my sheep, and I am known of mine. As the Father knoweth me, even so know I the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. And the other sheep I have, which are not of this fold, which is the northern kingdom, them also I must bring, and they shall fear my voice, and they shall hear my voice, and there shall be one fold and one shepherd. You hear this? So this is the whole point of us coming back to Yahweh Shai. Okay, he's going to be that one shepherd, and it was going to be one fold, the elect of the children of Israel. It says, therefore doth my Father love me, because I lay down my life, that I might take it again. No man taketh it from me, but I laid it down of myself. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it again. This commandment have I received of my Father. All right, and that's red letter. That's Yahweh Shai speaking. Okay, so anybody trying to bring you from Yahweh Shai, you gotta, you know, reevaluate.
For now, until something happened, he got deported from Costa Rica. Turns out they had overstayed their visas. A lot of them had expired passports, expired documents.
Look at this eye. It's all good though. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, we're not going to be stopped. They can't stop this.
But I'm getting ahead of myself, because first I need to explain to you melanation and how, like, what it is and how it changed.
The group believe that living in the sunshine of the tropics can make them superior beings, but this belief seems to be based on a discredited racial theory that the darker a person's skin becomes, the more their intelligence increases.
So if you lack melanin, you are genetically retarded.
His plan was to create a community entirely of what he called melanated people. But as it grew, white people were admitted. Anyone could now be melanated and gain greater enlightenment by getting brown in the sun of Costa Rica.
This is when Kayla Reed and
Scripture says, those that are given to change, see how his doctrine just keep changing up. This is Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 12. It says, the further by these, my son, be admonished of making of many books, there is no end. And much study is a weariness of the flesh, because Jake's trying to get too deep. It says, to my melanin and, you know, six protons, six neons and all this crazy shit, man. It says, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter, fear the Most High and keep his commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. All right, so this is the whole duty, man, for us to fear the Most High and to keep his commandments, man. Not even letting Edomites in. Okay, so let's grab this right here. Okay, because you notice how his you know, everything just keep changing. Okay, everything keep changing. Okay, so be, what is it? Beware. No. Let me see. Give. Let me grab this real quick. I'm ready to close out. Oh, here we go. Proverbs chapter 24, verse 21. It says, my son, fear thou Yahweh and the King. You see, fear thou Yahweh and the King, which is the Most High Yahweh and his only begotten son Yahweh Shai. It's Salakia. And meddle not with them that are given to change. And that's what you're going to notice about a lot of these guys. They change. They switch up, you know. They're constantly changing and switching up. Okay, switching up the doctrine. Okay, it's change everything here and there. And that's no different than what this guy did. It says, meddle not with them that are given to change. And this guy is given to change. Okay, he was preaching false doctrine, madness, bullshit. Okay. Now he got Esau in there. Her family was looking for her. He said, do you got crazy parents? Her family was looking for her. You know, talking about she mentally, you know, challenged.
Come on, the scene.
I messaged Nature Boy this exact same day.
People saying it's a cult.
Canada's a cult, like the U.S.
How does he have white people there? Reflection. This hardware that you are now looking at. This hardware is a mutation hardware from the archetype. You cannot become the archetype or be the archetype without having the archetype software. Consciousness. Thank you.
And this is what is missing in the...
That we know is Kayla.
I don't know a Kayla.
Sunray.
Oh, Sunray. Yes, she is healthy. She is beautiful. Oh, my. She is the happiest that, you know, she says she's ever been. We all encouraged her to just go live and let people know that you're okay and speak your own mind and tell them what's going on, because...
And she feels...
F so strong.
Have a cat? Stop scooping cat litter with Litter Robot, the highest rated self-cleaning litter...
What's your relationship like with Nature Bueno?
I don't even talk to him.
Not at all?
So I literally gave my money to him.
How much money did you give?
Well, I just gave him my debit card. He was buying a lot of materialistic objects.
It's about how you use the material thing. It's not about what the material thing means.
But do you really need a ping pong table?
Do you need sportsmanship to foster brotherhood? Yes, that is a utility. It's not just an object.
No, of course, yeah.
Now you just saw how both sides of that just flipped, you know. You know, one guy said one thing, another guy said another thing, and both of them, you know, sounded real smooth to the ears if you only hear one side. Okay, so you got to be mindful. You got to be mindful of these individuals, man. Completely gone.
It was Nature Boy.
It's not behind your back if he's going to interview you, though, right? It's about the movement. It's not about you anymore. He's kind of mad that...
Of course he's mad. He's always mad.
This is why I decided to leave Melanation.
Brainwashed his ass.
I don't like how the women are being treated.
Ran everybody that was there out.
Around this time... person
strangled on multiple occasions.
At this time, she's like his main girl, and he ends up getting her pregnant. She has a baby, and then there's this awful live stream.
Once you get emotional.
Did you throw up in your mouth a little bit? Because I did.
Let's play that back.
Different women at the same time.
You think I should keep this rolling?
Velvet left the group and listened to the disgusting reason why Nature Boy wanted to have kids with different women at the same time. This is according to Velvet. She said, he stated to me that the reason why he wanted all of the wives was that he wanted to impregnate all of us so that we can have his children, so that he can meet his children together, so that he can inbreed. Did you throw up in your mouth a little bit?
Hey, lock that nigga ass up, bro. Keep his ass where he at. Jake is gone. Jake is completely gone, man. This is the reality of our people. Now, let's play this too.
Him or bisexual or something. Now, I don't care. The reason why I'm bringing it up is because it becomes this recurring theme, and Nature Boy brings it up a lot.
I went into the flow of it, and I asked the universe, I want to know, what makes someone homosexual? Like, honestly, I want to know, why are there homosexual people in the world? Why does it exist in nature? Why do we do that? The answer came through me in the flow of my teaching. It just came out of me. The answer just came, and it was so crisp. If we don't live in a world that allows females to express themselves completely in freedom, out of them, collectively, then we summon the homosexual spirit. Nature does this to bring balance. Homosexuals, they have high IQs. Their creative level is out the roof because they tap into divine feminine. And they get status because they're smarter. They're made smart. They have a high IQ, right? So that gay people are very smart. When I learned this, I was amazed.
Yo, that's...
When I learned this, I was like, oh, wow, I never thought about the metaphysical reasons of being homosexual. I never thought of them. They tell me I have a disease. They said, you're sick. And they repeated it and repeated it and repeated it and repeated it and repeated it. I don't believe in going to no doctor to put no spell on me to sell medicine to me. I feel good. One person has herpes, that's a human being. We all have herpes. So I wanted to understand disease to teach about disease. A virus is an entity that cannot reproduce on its own. Hello? When you call me something, trust me. I go do my research very deeply. I know that me personally am not a homosexual. I know that I have no diseases. But if one of us have a disease, then we'll all have a disease. Because they're calling me the one with HIV, and I don't have HIV, unfortunately. But I do have HIV as far as what we all are. If one person has it, we all have it. I literally took an HIV test, and it didn't even matter. HIV is cancer.
He said, I literally took an HIV test, and it didn't even matter. Wow. And they're listening to this guy. Look at him. He is selling them a fucking pipe dream, man. Okay, and this is what Jake do. This guy got demons on him. He got, look at his eyes. His eyes are all over the place. He got demons on him, man. Be mindful of this, man. Be mindful of these individuals, man. Don't be taken by this madness. Okay, and these last days, a lot of people going to start falling for all kind of bullshit, man. You know? Now, when something becomes more about a leader of a group than, you know, the actual mission and message, guess what? You're in a cult, okay? You're in a cult, all right? So let's go ahead and play this. Let's read this, and I'm going to close out. This is Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11. It says, and he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of HaMashiach, till we all come into the unity of faith, and this is when we can all come together, till we all come into the unity of faith and having the knowledge of the Son of the Most High, unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of HaMashiach, that we henceforth be no more children tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine. This is what's happened to our people. They have been carried about with every wind of doctrine. It says by the sleight of men. You know, like a magician shows you the sleight of hand. By the sleight of men. This is why this guy's moving his hands like that and stuff, man. Somebody said, this live set you back, fam. No, he been back. Okay, that nigga been back. Talking about, he said he took an HIV test and it didn't even matter. What? But that's from all that gay sex and, sharing women and all this other madness they got going on over there, man. Not taking a bath and washing your ass, right? Come on. Somebody, they go get on the plane. They told him you can't get on the plane. They kept him off the plane because they was stank. Y'all ass was stank. Y'all too old for that, man, to be following some bullshit. Okay, you were too old to be following bullshit. It says, in cunning craftiness, whereby they lie in wait to deceive. And that's this guy. He's lying in wait to deceive. But speaking the truth in love may grow up into him that is, that's like, yeah, may grow up into him in all things, which is the head, even HaMashiach. So it's all about the Lord, man. When it becomes less about the Lord and more about these individuals, guess what? Leave, run, flee. Somebody say, yo, he just talking now. So they, the comic board, they laughing at him. And this is entertainment to a lot of these people, but at the same time, this shit is sick, man. All right?
Holy shit! I would have a transsexual wife, and I will. And I will. I do like transsexuals because I'm attracted to that. And I have to be honest about that. I don't feel like that makes me gay because I look at her as a woman. So the best head I ever got was from a transsexual. Unfortunately.
So mean. And insensitive. To so many people. Oh, world peace immediately. Michael, take me away. Sometimes in life, we bottle things in. Your mind really controls your health. Guys, do your yoga. Yes, I love yoga. Do you love yoga? I love yoga. Three, three, three. Three, three, three. Okay, so guys, listen. I'm a producer. I'm an actor. I'm an actor.
Hey, you know, Jake will fall for anything, bro. God. Jake, he nigga just told you he's an actor. Jake will fall for anything and be taken by this, man. 333. They in the back looking crazy. But this shows you that Jake is gone, man. Somebody go ahead and come board. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Jake, we need the Lord, man. The Lord got to come back and get this place right because it's all the way off. But that's the point. All right, let's see if we play a little bit more. But I'm pretty much done with this, man. Our prayers been edified to the hopeful elect. Shalom, Kwame Shirah, love, Baba Ball. Double honors to our teachers, the head elders, and apostles of the great millstone, who taught us his truth and truth and sincerity, man. All right, beware of these false teachers, these false prophets, and this madness, man. All right, let's play some more.
I'm an actor. I'm just not for sale.
Now, you notice he's acting very feminine now, okay, for whatever reason. These people got spirits on him. This guy has spirits on him, man. Demons on him. And them demons can't wait to find a self-indulged individual like this. Okay, and they use them for their purpose.
The best actor you've ever seen in your life.
As this video goes on, it gets worse and worse. All right, I haven't even gotten no further than this, I don't think. But when I got this far, I said, you know, I got to do a video on this. But this just goes to show you that these people, and not just him, but all the people that you see on the screen as well, you know, the other false teachers, they're all, you know, being led by demons. Okay, and we got to be mindful of this and be, you know, careful. And we don't be led by demons as well.
Guys, this is an urgent crisis. This is no joke.
Look at this guy.
In addition to him, he gave him like a strawberry instead of something else.
Did I ask for a strawberry? Bitch, did I ask for a strawberry? Huh?
No, my sweet.
Don't you ever in your motherfucking life give me no motherfucking strawberry unless I ask for one, motherfucker.
That's a three.
Let me tell you. See, at first, I'll be honest with you guys. I'll be 100% honest. When I was editing the footage, I was laughing. But then, after watching it over and over again,
right,
it wasn't funny anymore. Right. Then I was sad because it's ridiculous, like, in the beginning, but then when you look at their eyes, not Nature Boy, because he has crazy eyes, but when you look at the other followers' eyes, they're, like, dead inside. They're broken. They look sad. They look like...
And they say that the eyes is window to the soul. You got to look in an individual's eyes. You know, for guys, when you look in a man's eyes, you know, that tell you a lot about an individual. So you know, just look. That's why these guys be wearing shades. You know, they don't want to show their eyes because they got demons on them, man. Really. You know, you got a lot of agents and spies amongst us. And these same guys, you got to look in these guys' eyes, man. You know, and a lot of people just be on some bullshit. Really. So once you identify that, get the fuck from around. If you identify bullshit, somebody ain't right, somebody's spirit is off, somebody got demons on their ass, your best thing you could do is get from around, okay? Because they're going to self-destruct. And if you don't get away from that person, you're going to be caught up in the destruction, all right? You destruct the wave on your ass.
I have nothing left. And it's like, how bad do you have to feel about yourself to accept this shit, you know? It's like... they're probably saying worse things to themselves than what he's saying. That's why they're accepting that. And that's sad. You know what I mean? That's not funny. And it just, I hope now that he's in jail that maybe they love themselves, maybe forgive themselves for whatever they're punishing themselves for, they release their shame, have some self-respect.
These guys only going to get worse and worse as time goes on. So you got to get the fuck from around these guys, man. If a nigga ain't right, hey, we moving on. All right, if a nigga can't get it, we moving on. If a nigga ain't right, we moving on. Because they only going to get worse and worse.
Because nobody deserves to be treated like this.
Hey, scripture says, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Okay? Don't let no man take your crown.
It's awful. Now, if you thought that was bad, it gets worse. Brace yourself and consider this your trigger warning. The next clip I'm about to play.
Yeah, I'm going
to
leave right there because this is when he's going to talk about his... You know, what he do to his kids in front of his wife and all this other crazy shit, man. So, I'm leaving it at that. Shalom, Kwame Sherrallah, Baba Ball.